There were 6 total deaths at Action Park in New Jersey between 1978 and 1996. In 1982, there were 2 deaths occurring within a single week. One victim was a 15-year-old boy who drowned in the notorious Tidal Wave Pool. Now, HBO new documentary, Class Action Park, explores thrills and the dangers of the amusement park, which attracted a daring crowd in the 80s and 90s before its risky reputation eventually led to its downfall. There's a lot to unpack in this video, including a cringy Fox 5 New York video from 6 years ago documenting the water park's reopening, where an anchorman sexually harasses a co-anchor on air after repeat attempts to stop him. He also was the focus of a 2012 rape investigation. And another co-host of Fox 5 has ties to the Gambino crime family. So buckle up and get ready for a wild ride in this episode of the Dead Fed Files. The trailer for the new HBO documentary is complete with home video and advertising footage of children jumping off cliffs, shooting through water slides, and ambulances arriving on scene.
Of Action Park is a true crime story.
As you entered the park, you saw this thing.
And you're like, this is real.
The engineering behind this, if there was any engineering, was just nuts.
Build it higher, make it faster. People control the action.
Combine that with liquor and anything goes.
There were no rules. For a lot of kids, that was heaven.
And if you couldn't swim well, yikes.
I don't think you can understand a place like Action Park if you don't understand the kind of minds that built it.
A lot of people wish they could ignore rules. Gene actually did that.
Nobody would give him insurance, so he created his own insurance company and then insured himself.
It did bring sometimes a criminal element.
I don't know how many people died at Action Park, but it wasn't just one person.
Electrocuted.
Decapitated.
Fractured vertebrae.
Impaled on the bowl.
Had a heart attack.
Nobody should ever be the second person to die in a wave pool. Close the f***ing wave pool.
The action never stops.
Opened in Vernon, New Jersey in 1978, Action Park was one of the first modern water parks in the United States. Founder and CEO Eugene Mulvey Hill's philosophy was that amusement park visitors should be in control of their experience, envisioning a park where patrons manage their rides, including how fast and how high they went. And that's exactly what he created at Action Park.
There's nothing in the world like Action Park.
On July 8, 1980, the park saw its first fatality on the Alpine Slide. The slide featured a long cement and fiberglass-filled track that visitors rode down in a wheeled device. But first, parkgoers would take a ski lift to the summit, where they were greeted by photographs of injured children accompanied by a warning for riders to keep their arms inside their device. That fatality was a 19-year-old employee when he rode off the track and hit his head. According to New Jersey's records, there were at least 26 other serious head injuries and 14 fractures attributed to the Alpine Slide. Action Park's wave pool was state-of-the-art. In fact, it was one of the very first wave pools in the country. The large freshwater pool was a marvel of engineering that created random tidal waves of up to 3.5 feet tall. It sounds exciting in theory, but the danger of these sudden walls of water soon required the services of as many as a dozen lifeguards at a time, who each rescued an average of 30 swimmers every day, and earned the attraction the nickname the Grave Pool. And on July 24, 1982, a 15-year-old boy drowned. On August 1, 1982, within the same week of the previous death, a 27-year-old man from Long Island got out of his tipped kayak on the kayak ride experience. He stepped on a grate that was either in contact with or came too close to a section of live wiring for the underwater fans that somehow became exposed. He suffered a severe electric shock, which sent him into a cardiac arrest. Several other members of his family nearby were also injured. He was taken to a hospital in nearby Warwick, New York, where he died later of shock-induced cardiac arrest. The park permanently closed the kayak experience ride after the electrocution. In an article from the New York Times, Diane Beckcamps, a spokesman for the park, stated, quote, "Action Park will close this ride because people will always be intimidated by it." In 1984, a visitor reportedly suffered a fatal heart attack. It's believed to have been caused by shock of cold water exposure in the pool beneath the Tarzan swing. The pool was filled with natural spring water, which could get up to 30 degrees colder than the water in the park's other pools. Two more deaths in the Tidal Wave Pool occurred in 1984 and 1987. And then on July 28, 1987, a 55-year-old man sustained a fractured hip in a waterslide accident. On what might be the most tragic accident associated with the park was on July 26, 1992, when six were killed and 47 injured when a bus traveling to Action Park on Route 515 overturned and burst into flames. This tragedy was not the fault of the park, and the deaths are not considered part of the Action Park fatalities. Finally, on July 12, 1994, a 22-year-old man was killed while testing weight variances on the Space Shot prototype for Action Park. Action Park was forced into bankruptcy in 1995, but Action Park itself could quietly limp along for another year. When Action Park's 1996 season ended, the park did not reopen. The park reopened in 2014 with a new name, Mountain Creek Water Park, and now advertises its trained lifeguard staff and its stringent up-to-standard safety features. In a Fox 5 New York video interview on the reopening of Action Park, Greg Kelly, at the time co-host of Good Day New York with Rosanna Scotto, Kelly could not contain his enthusiasm when a colleague, Anna Gilligan, reported live from the newly renovated Action Park in a bikini. After Gilligan exited the water, Kelly stated, quote, "First of all, nice bathing suit."
Of the man who founded it. Thanks for being here.
It's great to be here. Thanks for coming out. What a day we have. It's beautiful here at Action Park.
So actually, before we get into our interview, if I could ask the people waiting to just keep on coming through and jumping off the Tarzan here. So tell me, what is different about Action Park this time around? You've got some old school things like this, but what else have you got?
Well, we've brought the action back. Yeah, we've got rides where you control the action, but we have a new ride that's unbelievable, the Zero G. Double loop, and the way you start is the floor drops out and you drop 100 feet into the ride. It's unbelievable.
So I got to ask you, because Action Park got a bit of a reputation back, some people got injured. How are you addressing the safety this time around?
Well, that was 30 years ago. The world has changed. I mean, when my dad started the park, he was the guy inventing the rides and bringing inventors in. Now it's highly regulated. Everything's engineered. We've brought back all the thrills, but none of the spills.
So I will be okay with this ride. I'm terrified, actually. Give me some advice on going off this.
Well, I think you'll do just fine. Just stay strong, keep your feet up, and hold on and have fun.
Okay, I'm going to try to do this. Our trusty intern Taylor here is going to take my stuff from me. I'm going to derobe here. I don't know what's scarier, the ride or taking off my clothes. Okay, I'll meet you on the other side. I'm going to jump off. Here you go, Taylor. Thank you.
Yep.
Okay.
Just say it. Wow, here she goes.
Anna looks
in
good.
In a two-piece.
Anna looks good.
Jane.
Whoa! Fun!
Nice job.
Wait, she's going to go swim and get a microphone.
Hey.
She'll give us
her. Oh, look at her. It's like out of a movie.
This is good. Where is she?
Wait a second.
We lost
what
Anna.
What happened to her?
Greg, you need to go rescue Anna.
Let's see. Let's just take a... Indeed. Yay!
Thank you, Taylor. Thank you, Andrew. I made it. I'm trying to put in my earpiece now so you guys can hear me. That was frightening, but it was really fun.
First of
and
all...
starting on Saturday...
Nice bathing suit.
They're open from 10:30
Greg,
to 7.
Stay What's appropriate. That?
Never mind.
Anna, you look great, and you handled that beautifully. I'm just trying to keep Greg in check.
Why are you so out of breath?
Thank you. What's that?
Nothing.
Oh, I'm
so what else is going on?
The adrenaline is pumping through my body.
Through your
So
yes.
In the next hour, I'm gonna go down something called a anxiety, high anxiety, and it's frightening. It's this tube that goes back and forth. So this place is open 7 days a week starting Saturday, 10:30 to 7, $40 for adults, 28 if you're under 4 feet tall. And having a lot of fun today, and we'll show you another ride in the next hour. I'm gonna go down with our interns. Should be fun.
Oh, that's great.
Bye, so guys. I'm gonna go put some clothes on.
Hold on a second. Right. No, not so fast, Anna. Let's let's see.
Anna.
Let's see. This is in New Jersey, right?
Be nice.
Oh, I just want to talk to her a little while.
Stop milking this shot.
Well, I'm just wondering, Anna, how long did it take you, let's see, to drive?
To get undressed?
To drive. Yeah, well, we saw that. How long is the trip? Oh, wait a second.
I think that's smart. Anna, go dry off. We'll see you in a little bit. What is wrong with you?
Just relax.
Okay, thanks, guys.
Thank you, Anna.
Okay, I guess we're done. Don't be so frowning at me.
In 2012, Kelly was investigated by the Manhattan District Attorney's Office upon an accusation of rape. Kelly was never arrested nor charged with a crime. After an investigation, the district attorney issued a letter stating that under New York State criminal law, the incident did not constitute a crime. The Huffington Post characterized the district attorney's findings as, quote-unquote, total exoneration of Kelly. Kelly returned to work February 13, 2012. His co-host on the show, Rosanna Scotto, is the daughter of Anthony Scotto, a former New York mobster in the Gambino crime family. Her maternal grandfather, Anthony Anastasio, was also a mobster for the Gambino crime family, who controlled the Brooklyn dockyards for over 30 years. So, would you dare take a ride down an Action Park ride next summer? Or will you decide it's just too risky? Let me know what you think in the comments below. And if you like this video, please consider subscribing for more DeadFed content.